Is it even possible to do extensions with oily nails? Absolutely! Keep watching and I will show you how. Hello, I'm Anastasia. Today I have a client with oily nails and she has hyperhidrosis. As you can see, the skin and nails, they're really moisty and wet, so this is gonna be a challenge, but I think together we can do it. First of all, you need to use alcohol-based sanitizer for hands because it dries them a little bit and it will help us. Then I am pushing back the cuticle with orange wood stick, and honestly, it's not really helping as the cuticle is really glued to the nail plate, so this is gonna be another challenge. So I decided to switch to electric nail file. I will use green ceramic bit to push back the cuticle and also to clean the spreading cuticle from the nail plate. And I need to repeat hand sanitizer application from time to time as the nails and the skin, it gets wet really fast, so we just need to redo it. Also, you can use baby powder, simply apply it on the skin and it will absorb a little bit of extra moisture. Unfortunately, I happened to not have baby powder on that day, but this is a really cool trick and it works. Now, after I did that, it is quite possible to push back the cuticle. So now I'm working on reverse rotation. So my bit is rotating in the opposite direction and I'm cleaning the opposite side. Once the cuticle is all pushed up, I switch to the softer ceramic bit, which is pink, and I'm going to clean a little bit under the cuticle and push it up a little more. I'm doing all this not only for the sake of manicure and beautiful cuticles, because this is a must-have if you live in Russia, but also this is part of the prep. Prep is crucial for nails, especially with hyperhidrosis, because if you will not prep them correctly, then the product will simply not stay. Since this client has not only hyperhidrosis, but also her nails are a little bit bitten, the cuticle is really tight to the nail plate, and since the skin is oily, if we will leave some of the cuticle on the nail plate, it will absorb all the oils under the product, so it will lift. After I pushed it back, it is time to trim it. And one way to do that is to use electric nail file, but with oily skin, with hyperhidrosis, it is extremely hard, so I decided to do it easier and use special manicure scissors. It is important to not cut it too deep, only remove the dead skin, which is the white tissue. For hangnails, you can also use scissors, or if you feel more confident with nippers, you can use them as well. Now it is time to prep the nail, and usually we prep them all together. I mean, you prep all 10 nails and then you do application on all 10 nails, right? But here, unfortunately, we cannot do this because once you take off the surface shine, around 1 minute passes and it's back there. So I had to prep only 2 nails at a time, and that was the only way, unfortunately. I'm using 180 grit to remove the surface shine, and I don't know if you can see it through the camera, but the moisture comes back so quickly, so we need to be fast here. Now make sure you filed off all the shine, but do not overfile nails, this is also important. Once you're done, clean the dust, and here is the first trick on working with oily nails. You need to use dehydrator and apply it not only on the nail plate, but also on the surrounding skin. And then do it again. And again. So it's okay if you apply it 2 to 3 times. It will help us to absorb more moisture and make the skin a little bit dry. Then I apply the base coat. You can use any sock off base coat, but it is important that you apply it super thin. Do not forget about the margin near the cuticle and along the sidewalls, that should always be there. Once you are done, cure in LED for 30 seconds. And now let's do the extensions. Today I will be using Polygel, this is Russian brand called Cosmo Profi, and I have to do this, push back the sidewalls from the thumb, because otherwise I will not be able to apply the product. I mean, if it was acrylic, we could just hold this finger. By the way, if you would like to see how I do it with acrylic, do not forget to subscribe as I will share it later too. So for gel or polygel, we need to do something like that. And keep in mind that the skin is oily and we do not want that oil to get into the product. So basically I'm building the short free edge. Then I cure in LED for 1 minute. And then we're going to separate it from the skin. So this technique I always use for short beaten nails because this is a good way to help us nail technicians to fit the form. Now, it is important to not press too much on the product, so the thickness of the product should not go under the nail, it should be on top of it. Now, I carefully separate it with the orange wood stick, and now I can easily fit the form. The nails are rather wide, so I think the best solution will be whether coffin shape or almond shape, and the client decided to go with almond. So now I'm building the structure, I'm working with polygel again and using a little bit of liquid called slip solution so the brush will not stick, and we're not going to do extreme length here, but as you've seen, the nails are short but not extremely short, so we can afford doing this kind of medium length, and I think it will make the hands really look elegant and feminine. Now freeze cure for about 10 to 15 seconds and then I will slightly pinch the base and cure for remaining 1 minute. Now we can take off the form and build the structure of the nail. I think it already looks kind of beautiful. This time I'm taking more product as I'm about to build the apex and the whole structure of the nail. Usually I first work near the cuticle area, and here is another tip on working with hyperhidrosis nails. Make sure that you leave a margin between the cuticle a little bit bigger than you usually do, because remember, the skin wants to give oil to the nail and we do not want that as it will not provide it good adhesion. So it is okay if the margin will be a little bigger, but at least the nails will last. When applying the product, make sure that you have enough product in the center where the apex is, and with polygel, since we can work with it until we cure it in the lamp, I recommend you to take your time and fix everything before curing. Like now, I noticed a couple of bubbles and it's better to pop them now because once it's cured, we will have a little hose down there. Now freeze cure for 10 to 15 seconds and this time I'm pinching with tweezers and cure for remaining 1 minute. Now we can take off the sticky layer and file the nail. First, I'm filing the surface with 180 file, and on top of the oily nails and hyperhidrosis, we notice that the client has also very sensitive skin, which means if I even lightly touch it with the file, it will hurt and we may have additional hangnail, and we do not want that. That's why as I go closer to the cuticle and to the sidewalls, I switch to electric nail file. I'm using my favorite carbide bead, it's cone-shaped with a green abrasive. The product there should be super thin. Once you neglect a small part of it, the product will lift within a few hours. This is how it works. And the last step will be buffing the cuticle. I'm using a red abrasive diamond bead, and yes, it is red, I know it looks black, but that's because I used infrared sterilizer and it changed its color. So I'm doing this to make the skin glow and to get rid of all these small hangnails. I recommend you to do this right before applying the top coat, after you buff the nail, after you filed everything. Now we need to clean the dust and apply the top coat. Oh my god, it took me a while. I mean, the whole service was about 3.5 hours. My client got really tired and fell asleep, but once she woke up, she was like, wow, like, oh my god, I cannot believe that my nails can look like that. So we decided, since we already have long, beautiful nails, why not decorate them? One of the best way to add some simple design is, of course, adding some rhinestones. So I am taking Bling On Gel by Accents, I always use it for securing rhinestones, and apply a line and then create some kind of a triangle and apply blue Swarovski rhinestones. I add the biggest one in the center and then two on the sides. By the way, these rhinestones, they are not just blue. In the camera they look only blue. In the real life, if you take a look at them at a certain angle, they also look red, which is kind of cool. I also added some white rhinestones on the sides, and then I realized that I also have a blue caviar beads, so we decided to decorate them as well. This may look like it is a setting, but also it actually helps them to be glued together so they will last longer. Now, after you added all the caviar beads fully cured for 1 minute in LED and to make them stay there forever, or at least until next infill, make sure to outline each of them with a no-cleanse top coat. Then cure it once again in LED and we are done. Can you guys believe that we had something like this at the beginning? Super short, beaten and oily nails, and this is what we have at the end. The client was so happy and so am I. Thank you guys so much for watching and let me know, have you ever worked with clients who have hyperhidrosis and which product and technology do you use for them? I personally think that polygel and acrylic works better for me, so if you would like to see how to deal with these nails with acrylic as well, make sure to subscribe so you will not miss it. See you in my next video. Goodbye!